Dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Over the last 2 weeks, we talked about something or a minor issue in the deen that some people might hold as trifle in their deen. However, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam considered as one of the major, you know, causes of punishment in the grave. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, as reported by Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, that إياكم ومحقرات الذنوب فإنهن يجتمعن على المرء يهلكن. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam a long time ago sent a warning for us, for the followers of Islam till the day of judgment, that anything that you might hold a trifle in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's a major sin. Particularly when you do this or that, you know, sin in purpose, and you keep doing it. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِيَّاكُمْ وَمُحَقَّرَاتُ الذُّنُوبِ, something that you might think it's, there is no problem doing it. How can Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punish me for doing this? Yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned you. So you have to take precautions before doing that action. On the other side, as those trifle issues, the minor sins, if they come together, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in another hadith, that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hold a person being accountable for those sins, wal'ayazu billah, they will ruin him. Ruin him. On the other side, the acts of worship that you can do every day and night, small things, that also you might hold a trifle, a word, giving a charity, making tasbih, reading a letter from the Quran. You might consider also these as trifle good deeds. However, if you hear what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about those minor good deeds, you will keep doing them day and night. And we will talk about them. Some of them, not all of them. Because we cannot count all of them in one khutbah or one speech. They need more than a speech to cover all of them. And even if we are able to cover all of them, hopefully, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the power to do them. The Muslim, whether he is a male or female, can do those. Whether he is young or old, whether he is rich or poor, he can do those acts of worship. He can do them constantly. He can do them without stopping, because they do not cause him any physical effort. They do not ask him or do not oblige him to exert himself. Just thinking that, you know, that just using your hands, that just using your tongue, that's it. But the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for that person is bountifully. And listen to the ayah at the last part of Surah Al-Nahl, chapter number 16, verse number 97. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ فَلَنُحْيِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبًا وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْرَهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, interpreting the meaning is, whoever, whether he is male or female, while he is in a state of Islam, while he is a believer, if he works righteousness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and look at the requirements. First, work his righteousness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, or while he is a believer, while he believes in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the reward for that person is what? Also two. First, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him a good life in respect with everything he handles in his life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him contentment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide him with lawful provision. and in the hereafter. The unseen. Something that falls in the domain of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised that person who sincerely works righteousness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What will happen to him in the hereafter? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْرَهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. The same. As you do good works, deeds in your life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you in proportion to the best of your deeds, which means Jannah in the hereafter. Something that all of us work for. So, consider this ayah and consider the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that is reported by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. بادروا بالأعمال فتنا كقطع الليل البهيم يصبح المرء مؤمنا ويمسي كافرا والعياذ بالله ويمسي مؤمنا ويصبح كافرا والعياذ بالله. So consider this hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and ask yourself, are you ready for the journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Are you ready for the test? Are you ready to be examined? Do you think your deeds are enough for you to save you in the day of judgment? Consider this question. Do you have many good deeds to save you on the day of judgment or not? If yes, then welcome. Continue doing them. If not, why you stop doing them? And believe me, brothers, if you ask yourself this question, believe me, the answer is so hard to be answered or provided. Do we have more good deeds or enough good deeds to save us on the day of judgment or not? The Prophet ﷺ said, urging you to do good deeds. Any kind of good deeds you can do in this life. Do not waste your time. Do not waste a minute of your life. This is the capital that you have in this life. As you see people around you, they are caring about money, collecting money, living a good life, also do the same. But save something for you to the hereafter. Something that will remain forever with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hasten to do good deeds before there come tribulations. And look at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he characterized, when he depicted how the situation, what is the situation of people at those tribulations. A mu'min, in the beginning of his day, will believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And something will happen to him. Something will affect his deen badly. To the extent that he will leave the deen completely, wal'iyadu billah, within a number of hours. When night comes, when evening comes, he will leave the deen, he will be a kafir, wal'iyadu billah. And the same. At night, he will sleep as a believer. But something will happen to him that will make him change his deen, wal'iyadu billah. And that thing is what? Selling his religious commitment with some worldly gain. Something that will not stay with him, and him himself will not stay with it. Because both, they will leave each other. There is a moment of time that all of us will leave this life. And also the ni'mah, the happiness, will leave us. So consider about this hadith. Those kind of works, they are very great in number. And the believer is the one who has a sincere intention to do them. The one who asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give him power to do them. The mu'min, the believer, is the one who asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep him persistent in doing them. The believer is the one who asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely to accept them from him after doing them. First of all, coming to the prayer, praying in jama'ah, congregation. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrated that. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and subhanAllah, if you count how many houses, how many dwellings that we lose every day because not coming to the jama'ah. من غدا إلى المسجد أو راح أعد الله له نزلا كلما غدا أو راح. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever goes to the masjid to perform the salah in jama'ah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will prepare for him an honorable dwelling or house in paradise for him as long as he goes and comes. So how many houses do we lose every day? Also, listen to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he said, just something that you can say with your tongue every morning. It will not cost you, it will not take 5 minutes of your time. من قال لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير 100 times في يوم. Whosoever says these words, this kind of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is no God save Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For him belongs the dominion, belongs everything in this life, belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for everything he gives you. And he has power, he's able to do everything. He has power all over everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you see this 100 times a day or in your day, look at the rewards that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepares for you. The first, that كانت له كعدل عشر رقاب كعدك عشر رقاب. It will be acted, it will be for him as if he released 10 slaves. Secondly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him 100 hasana. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will erase 100 sayyah from him. And nobody will come on the day of judgment with the same work unless someone said more than him. So, for each word, for each part of the sentence, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you a reward. Just saying with your tongue. Just, you know, repeating with your tongue. Moving your tongue. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. That's all. Just keep doing or saying this in the morning or in the evening. Also, Ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه said, من قال سبحان الله وبحمده 100 times حطت عنه خطاياه ولو كانت مثل زبد البحر. رواه مسلم. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whosoever says in 100 times, either in the morning or in the night, Subhanallah wa bihamdi, glorify is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will erase all his sins, even if they are like the foam of the sea. So Subhanallah wa bihamdi, it does not cost you anything. Just move your tongue. Believe me, it will not cost you 2 or 3 minutes of your time. While driving your car, going to your work, going to your class, just repeat this, see this. And on the day of judgment, inshallah, you will see how much hasanat you will get. You will be credited because of saying these words. Tasbih of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, من شهد الجنازة كما رواه أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه من شهد الجنازة حتى يصلي فله قيراط ومن شهدها حتى تدفن فله قيراطان. قيل وما القيراط يا رسول الله أو القيراطان يا رسول الله؟ قال مثل الجبلين العظيمين أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whosoever attends the funeral procession, جنازة, and wait or performs the funeral prayer, Allah will give him 1 qirat in the Jannah. And whosoever waits till the burial of the janazah, Allah will give him 2 qirats. The Prophet was asked, how much is this qirat? The Prophet ﷺ said, like the great mountains. So, if Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, when he heard this, He said, how many kirats did we lost? Did we lose? So every day, you can get piles of hasanat without doing, without efforting in yourself. Saying words, repeating, contemplating even. Something very easy. And we said before that the way to the Jannah is so easy. Do not make it hard for yourself. Do not think that it is so hard to enter Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala offers Jannah for free for you. And you insist in doing something that keeps you away from the Jannah. Listen, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, as reported by Abu Dharr, every morning, when you feel that your body is okay, when you wake up, and you are able to see, to hear, to walk, to touch everything, to do, everything is in its place, then there is some kind of sadaqah that you have to pay for being healthy again and being alive again. Just make tasbih, see subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. And it's enough for you to perform two rak'ah, the duha rak'ah, the mid-morning rak'ah. Just two rak'ah that you lose. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to do those two rak'at, Salat al-Duha. Many different kinds of good deeds, minor ones, that we might think that they are trifling. But on the Day of Judgment, when you will see your record, you will find those hasanat. And you will be happy when you see the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, resulting from the good deeds. But before that, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the help. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you sincere intention. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep you persistent in doing them. Do not exert yourself one time and stop after this. The custom or the tradition of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam family was that if they started something, they would persist in doing it. As Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said, the most beloved actions by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are those. The person when he does them, he is persistent in doing them, even if they are little. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like at the biles without sincere intention, without dua, without, you know, exerting yourself. He looks at if they are minor, but you are keeping doing them. This is the custom of the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. أقول قولي هذا وصف الله العلي العظيم لي ولكم أن الله وجعل كل من الأجر الحمد لله رب العالمين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين الظالمين الذين يصدون عن سبيل الله ويبغونها عوجا وهم بالآخرة كافرون وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله ثم أما بعد. One of those good deeds, something that we should today. When you hear someone of your brothers is sick, when you hear that he is absent, when you do not hear anything about him, what you should do? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked the Sahaba, "Man minkum al-yawma asbaha sa'iman? Who amongst you become or is fasting today?" Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, "I am." Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Who amongst you followed a janazah or attended a janazah?" Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, "I am." Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Who amongst you visited today a sick brother?" Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, "I am." Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Who amongst you paid something or paid a charity, paid food for a poor person?" Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, "I am." Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, ما اجتمعنا في امرئ الا دخل الجنه وكما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. If those traits, merits, come together in a person, he will enter easily Jannah. And today, when you see one of the brothers here, and do not ask if he comes to the masjid or not, still he is your brother. And you have to ask about him. He has a surgery today, a very dangerous surgery, a new operation. And at least, if you will not go to visit him, just pick up the phone and call him and ask how is he doing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you hasana. Allah will appoint an angel asking you why you are doing this. If the thing that drives you to do this, just loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or for the sake of Allah, Allah will love you as you do this. So, if you would like to be or to deserve or to receive the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just pick up the phone and say, Salaamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, how are you doing? Just, that's it. And hang up. This is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we think that we are living in a time that is different from the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They lived a very tough time. But look at the hasanat. Look at the good deeds that they used to do before Fajr prayer and after Fajr prayer. Because they feared Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They thought about the hereafter. When they will stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment, looking around to have one hasana to save oneself. Think about it and let the answer be yours. اللهم البلغت اللهم فشل اللهم عفنا عفو عنا اللهم عفنا عفو عنا وانشر خيرك تسلمنا اللهم انصر الإسلام وعز المسلمين اللهم انصر الإسلام وعز المسلمين اللهم انصر إخوانا المستضعفين في كل مكان اللهم كن لهم ولا تكن عليهم اللهم زلزل الأرض من تحت أقدام أعدائهم اللهم اغفر لنا ما قدمنا وما أخرنا وما أسررنا وما أعلنا وما أنت أعلم به منا عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون وقوموا بالصلاة. الله أكبر.